On this video, we go over how to find the volume of a cylinder, which is also called a right circular cylinder, which looks like a can, a cylinder. And the formula for volume is pi r squared h. We go over that. And then we do this problem at the bottom here, as well as find approximate answers to this problem. In this video, we're going to go over how to find the volume of a cylinder. Well, what's a cylinder? It kind of looks like a can of soup, but it might be really short and fat or really tall and thin. So here's a picture of a cylinder. This would be sort of a short, fat can. And notice when you're looking at a cylinder, the bottom is a circle and the top's a circle. So I'm trying to draw in 3D and I'm not a very good drawer, but hopefully you get the idea. And so on the bottom and the top where the circle is, remember that circle has a radius and that's halfway across to the center. And then the height is how tall the can is. Now, of course, the cylinder could be on its side as well. So the circles could be on the ends left and right and you could think of the height going across. And I'm going to use this model. Now, to talk about the volume of a cylinder, we talk about how much stuff that holds, basically. That's what volume refers to. And you already need to know how to find the area of a circle using the formula for a circle, a equals pi r squared. If you're not sure of that, look at my videos on finding the circumference and area of a circle. And I like to write the area as a equals r squared times pi. That's, of course, the same thing as pi times r squared. And you should also be familiar with the formula for the volume of a rectangular solid, which is just like a box. And so there's a length, and there's a width, and there's a height, and you multiply those together, and that will give you the volume of a box. So here's our picture again of some cylinder. And so we've got the height of the cylinder, that might be the height of the can. And then where the circle is at the bottom or the top, there's going to be a radius. So here's the idea. You know that the area of the circle is pi r squared. So that would just be, let's say, the area of the circle at the bottom. This is also the same r, right? But then it's not just the area we want. We want the volume of this whole can. When you do the volume, you have to multiply the height. You know, there's infinitely many circles, right? Up through the top. You could think of it that way. So the volume of a cylinder, we write, well, it's the area of the bottom piece, which is pi r squared, and then we have to multiply it by the height. That's how you get the volume of something that's kind of consistently just going straight up. So if you've got like a star at the bottom and then a star going up, if you have a box at the, a square at the bottom and going up, a rectangle at the bottom, a circle at the bottom, you just multiply it by the height. And this is usually just written as pi r squared h. Now, of course, it doesn't matter the order you multiply those in. You could say the volume is r times h times pi. That's really all the same thing. But that's what we want to use. The volume for a cylinder is pi r squared h. That's the way you're usually going to see it written. So let's try a problem. So let's find the exact volume of a cylinder if the radius is 4 feet and the height is 10 feet. Well, this is convenient. I was given both the radius and the height. So remember, the formula is pi r squared h, and we know that r is 4 feet. We know that h is 10 feet. And I'm going to leave off the feet part when I fill in the values over here, but remember at the end, if you have an r times a r times a h, you're going to end up with a feet times a feet times a feet, which are cubic feet, and volume is going to be in cubic something, cubic inches, cubic feet, cubic meters, etc. So let's go ahead and plug this in for this problem. Pi, well, it says exact, you just got to write a pi. And then r squared, okay, so that's 4 times 4, and then h is 10, and so note that's going to be cubic feet, because you have 4 feet times 4 feet times 10 feet. Instead of writing feet down 3 times, I'm going to write feet cube, which could also be written as cubic feet. In English, sometimes you'll see it written that way. All right, so what's this give me? I've got 4 times 4 times 10, so 16 times 10 is 160 pi cubic feet. Now that is the exact answer to this problem. Now, usually it's kind of tricky when you leave things in terms of pi, because you don't really get a feel for what it is, but you could probably estimate it. You know, pi is a little more than 3, so 3 times 160 would be about 480. So it's going to be more than 480 cubic feet. But of course, this is very big. Imagine something that is 4 feet just for the radius. That means it's 8 feet across and it's 10 feet high. That's a pretty big thing. You could fit a lot of people in there. So now, let's estimate this. Okay, so let's approximate the volume using the approximation of 3.14 for pi. Now we all know that pi does not equal 3.14. That's just a common approximation that we use. If pi was 3.14, we wouldn't have a special name for it. We would just plug in 3.14 in the first place. So let's take this 160 pi and put in, I'm going to put the volume as approximately equal, it's not going to exactly equal it, times 3.14. And then what's that? Well, you can do that on the side or get out a calculator and do that, and that is 502.4 cubic feet. So it's approximately 502.4 cubic feet. Remember, I knew it was going to be more than 480. Because if I plugged in 3, I would get 480. Now, what if I said approximate, or how about this? Let's say round answer to the nearest cubic foot from this answer. So we did this approximation with 3.14, and to the nearest cubic foot, what would that be? Well, we've got 502.4, closer to 502 or 503. Well, after the decimal point is a 4, so we round down, it's going to be 502 cubic feet. So that's if I was rounding to the nearest cubic foot. This is just the approximation, right? Not the exact answer when I use 3.14 for pi. Now, sometimes, what's another common approximation? You could use 22 sevenths. So approximate, do it one more time, the volume using 22 sevenths for pi. Again, remember, pi does not equal 22 sevenths. This is only going to give us approximation only. So the volume would be 160 times 22 sevenths. Cubic feet. And again, I should use my little squiggly line to show it's not exactly equal to that, but then I could say what this equals. And so you could do 160 times 22 divided by 7, which gives me 3520 sevenths cubic feet. All right, but that's not written as a mixed number, so let's go ahead and divide, because usually that would be how you would want to write it. You wouldn't want to leave it as 3520. So if you just do division, 7 into 3520, you could do that on your scratch paper. It's going to go in 502 times. Well, that's no surprise. It should be pretty similar to what we had before. And let's see, the remainder was 6, so this is in 6 sevenths. Cubic feet. So now we've done this problem a few ways here. Here's the exact answer, 160 pi cubic feet. Here's an approximation using 3.14 for pi. Here's if I happen to round it to the nearest cubic foot. And here's the interesting part. When I use 22 sevenths, notice that I got 502 and 6 sevenths. If I rounded that, it would give me 503 cubic feet if I rounded that to the nearest cubic foot. So when you start rounding and you use different approximations for pi, when you round to the nearest cubic foot, it may be different. So your question is, which way should you do it? Well, basically, it kind of depends on your directions. So if you're asked for an exact answer, just keep everything in terms of pi. If you're asked to approximate it, then you should be given what you're going to use for your approximation. So 3.147 is a common decimal approximation, and 22/7 is an approximate fractional approximation. And then if you were also rounding it to the nearest cubic foot, you'd remember you're not going to go anywhere after the decimal place, right? You're going to round. And the reason I rounded up is 6/7 is almost one more number, right? So 502 plus about one. Right? So that's an example of how to find the volume of a cylinder. And so have fun trying some more problems.